Have you ever heard, or maybe said yourself, but my students could never work quietly like that? Yeah, me too. And our beliefs in this area can be the roadblock to effectively knowing what is differentiated instruction and writing, because we believe the suggestions others make won't work in our classroom. Hi there, I'm Marian Busfield here from Engaging Curiosity to empower you to take charge in the classroom by supporting you with classroom management strategies and resources. Today, I am sharing about the connection between effective classroom management and differentiation in instruction from my blog post, How to Confidently Know What is Differentiated Instruction in Writing. Thank you for joining me today, and please remember to press like and subscribe below. That is the best way you can help me to reach other teachers. So let's start with differentiating in writing and how it connects to the importance of your classroom management plan. Mary Shea of Canisius College, in her 2015 article, Differentiating Writing Instruction, Meeting the Diverse Needs of Authors in a Classroom, from the Journal of Inquiry and Action in Education, says, differentiating calls for effective classroom management, another topic in itself. So if you are already struggling with classroom management, the idea of adding differentiation to the list of jobs you need to do is a bit overwhelming. This might also leave you struggling with a growth mindset in this area. And there may be a few tips about that on my blog post on growth mindset that will help. Find the link down below. Otherwise, you will find that effective small group instruction and student collaboration will depend upon your classroom management plan and effective classroom management techniques. Just let me mention here that any of my blog posts or other information that I refer to is shared down below. So classroom management and differentiation go hand in hand. Without differentiation, behavior is often escalated, which impacts what classroom management strategies you need to implement. Never mind the time, energy, and disruption behavior management takes. For more on that, I encourage you to read my blog post on what is classroom management and why is it important, to understand the pillars of classroom management strategies that I share in posts throughout my blog. I won't dig into that here because, as Mary Shea says, that's a whole conversation in itself. If you are struggling with classroom management and want to set some goals in this area, I do offer a free classroom management checklist. Again, the link is down below. This checklist will help you to assess what you already have successfully implemented. Additionally, there is room for you to do some goal setting next steps for what will work best in your context, which is unique to you. So once you have started to work on classroom management, what's next for differentiating in writing? Well, meaningful work. For a brief video on meaningful work for differentiating in writing, join me on my next video, How to Create Incredible Writing Growth in First and Second Grade Effortlessly, or Write Real Things. Thank you for joining me for this video on the connection between differentiation in instruction and classroom management, and I hope you join me again soon. In the meantime, please share a connection or goal for your own differentiation or classroom management in the comments below. And please press like, subscribe, and notify so I can help as many teachers as possible. See you soon. Bye now.